Hello everyone, nice to see you back. So we're coming to another important and interesting part of chemical kinetics. Chemical kinetics, we started with the rates of the reactions, and we said some reactions are slow, some fast, some moderate, and we told you that thermodynamics gives an answer to the feasibility of a reaction. Spontaneity conditions were given by delta G gives the energy, but the rates of the reactions are studied in the branch of chemical kinetics. And after that, we told you there is a rate law, rate equation, rate of the, what is the rate of the equation, what is rate law, what is order of a reaction, what is molecularity of a reaction, what is the difference between order and molecularity. I'm just giving a recap of the questions which are important for your exam. These questions which I talk, they have been asked in the previous body of papers. What is the rate of a reaction? What is the rate law? What is the difference between rate and rate law? What is molecularity of a reaction? And what is order of a reaction? And how to find the order of a reaction experimentally? Difference between molecularity and order of a reaction. What is a zero order reaction, students? We studied about that. What is the first order reaction? We derived the formulas, integrated rate equations for zero order, first order. For gas phase also, we derived the formulas. We have done some numericals last time, which were asked in previous year papers. And I'm happy that you could solve all those numericals. So that is the main thing, that the far success, there is no substitute for hard work. Without hard work, there will be no success anywhere in any part of the world. That we understood over a period of time. Let it speak to any top player of the world. Hima Das, you know, is the best runner in the world now. She is Indian, and how she got a gold medal. And if you will see the hard work she is doing is unbelievable. Is badminton player also, is cricket player also, they are doing practice day and night. I mean, their life goes in that. So much work is being done before they come to that level. So here we are with you again. My main purpose is to motivate you people, inspire you people, so that you can dream high in this world and go for higher goals and higher purpose in life. And I always say, students, your health should be a very important factor. You should not fall sick. That's very essential. So we have to keep ourselves mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally fit. Our life will be decided by our habits, our daily routines, and the rituals which we follow. And the successful people in the world are very clear about that. So they know what they are doing every day. It's not that they will do once a week. They are doing every day, following a very definite type of habits and routines. So we know about that secrets. I will expose you sometime on another video. So the last session of this is very interesting and very important, that we know about the reactions. Now we studied the effect of temperature on the reactions. That temperature is very important factor in our life. And by increasing the temperature, we could speed up the rates of the reactions because the fraction of the molecules which have energy equal to or greater than activation energy increases was given by Arrhenius. And that equation is very important for exams. We know about what is important already. Here you can see on the screen the effect of catalyst on the reaction rates. You are seeing, oh, catalyst, my God, they are so important now. Many reactions are not possible without catalyst. Then what the catalyst is doing, how it is increasing the speed of a reaction, catalyst. So what we are talking is the effect of catalyst on reaction rates. Example, I have given decomposition of potassium chlorate. I'm saying if I have 2KClO3, if I want to heat it and decompose it, this reaction is slow, but you add manganese dioxide, a pinch of manganese dioxide, it becomes fast. So we are saying that in this reaction, manganese dioxide is acting as a catalyst. It is acting as a catalyst, students. And we are so familiar with catalyst now. That catalyst increases the rate of the reaction, you are saying. What is the definition of a catalyst? First of all, question, what is a catalyst? You are saying, what is a catalyst? And you know, catalyst is a substance which speeds up a reaction but is chemically unchanged at the end of the reaction. When the action has finished, you would have exactly the same mass of catalyst as you had in the beginning. Is an important statement, students. Here you are using manganese dioxide as a catalyst. You do the reaction. After the end, you can find that there is no loss in mass of this. It is coming back again as much as you started with. Experimentally, you can verify this. So this is the definition of the catalyst we are talking about. The speed is increased. Some of the examples, student. Some of the examples. You know the manufacture of ammonia by Haber process. Nitrogen gas plus 3 hydrogen gas gives 2 ammonia gas. Can you tell me what is the catalyst which is used in this reaction? Yes, your answer required.
Yes, sir. It is in Haber's process. It is iron.
Iron. And there is a promoter also, I think, in this which is used. Probably, sometimes you may have seen something like this.
Molybdenum. Molybdenum.
What is that?
Molybdenum.
Promoter.
Promoter.
I revise, I do things because sometimes questions are there in your exam, so you don't know what question they will ask. They don't ask the catalyst, they ask the promoter. What is this rule of this? This improves the activity of the catalyst. Activity of the catalyst. You have seen powdered forms of the catalyst are being used for hydrogenation reactions. You are aware of the hydrogenation reaction?
Yes, sir.
What we call it as a catalytic hydrogenation. Can you give me an example of catalytic hydrogenation? Okay, give me example of catalytic hydrogenation, students. Remember anything like that?
Yes, sir.
Organic chemistry.
Yes, sir. Just 2 minutes. Catalytic hydrogenation.
You aware of hydrogenation of alkenes?
Yes, sir. In presence of nickel, palladium, and platinum.
Either of them.
Yes, sir. Either of them.
What is the role of this nickel?
It acts as a catalyst to speed up the hydrogenation process.
The name is catalytic hydrogenation. There is a stereochemistry also involved in this. Very interesting things are there. What you will get? Interesting thing, because you see that what you are going from sp2 hybridization to sp3 hybridization, and usually this approach is important. How this is coming, they are coming from the same side, then what will happen, what type of products will be formed? You know, this is another interesting thing. If these compounds become optically active, or sometimes depends the arrangement of the atoms around the space, is called stereochemistry. Itself is an interesting topic. Here we are not talking about that. We just told you about the role of the catalyst here. The speeding of the reaction. Here you have conversion of sulfur dioxide into SO3 during contact process of sulfuric acid. You know, they have asked a question once in the paper, which catalyst is used in the contact process? Sulfuric acid is the most important reagent. You know about that, king of chemicals. Why you call sulfuric acid as the king of chemicals? Your answer required. These are live sessions, interactive sessions. You are participating with me all the time.
Sir, because it is sir, it is a very strong acid and is used in preparation of many other chemicals.
It has huge industrial applications and yes, large sir. Number of uses. So that's why it is the king of chemicals. In fact, in every country, how much sulfuric acid you produce depends, shows the rate of your economy also. It has so many uses, that's the thing. Industrially, applications are very high. So what is happening here? You are having SO2 plus O2. What it is forming? 2SO3. And what you are using? Vanadium pentoxide is a catalyst. You see, the transition elements are acting as very good catalyst. And an answer to that will be given because we have in our course the D block elements. What is the importance? Why they are acting as a catalyst? We will study that also. Everything will be studied. It's very interesting. Because this ultimately we prepare sulfuric acid from this oleum and oleum to sulfuric acid. Already we told you about the hydrogenation of the double bond. You know, we have already discussed this type of things. Some of the catalysts which you are using in our chemistry labs and industries are important. Now, what is the story? What catalyst has something to do with the activation energy or why it increases the rate of the reaction? Why? It's an important question for exam always. Why the catalyst will increase the rate of the reaction? What is the catalyst you answered? Examples of the catalyst you gave. And further he says why? What the catalyst is doing basically? We are saying there is a relationship between catalyst and activation energy. You see that every reaction having activation energy, we already told you. And last time we have made a graph also of this. You are aware of that. What is that graph? You have plotted the, this is our potential energy of the reaction, potential energy of the reaction. You made a plot of that versus reaction coordinate, reaction progress, students. So you can see that this is these are our reactants, intermediate. We told you about the activated complex. And then you can see the products. And you said there is a activation energy which is required for the reactants to form the products. So one thing about the temperature, we studied the effect of temperature. In the effect of temperature, what we said? When you studied the effect of temperature, if you increase the temperature, what happens? Rate increases. Yes. True?
Yes, sir.
Here you said the fraction of molecules which have energy equal to or greater than activation energy increases. Then what is happening here? You can see that there is a decrease in activation energy. This is a catalyzed reaction. Catalyst added, activation energy has decreased. But why the activation energy will decrease? So, as I said, the lower the activation energy, faster the reaction. Faster the reaction. So, why and how the activation energy will be decreased? That is a question. What we are trying to say. Important question for exam. Here I have. This is when you have added the catalyst. Students, you see that there is a decrease in activation energy, as you can see. This is your activation energy now decreased by the addition of the catalyst. So it is believed that catalyst provides an alternative pathway or reaction mechanism by reducing the activation energy. I hope you have your colored pens to mark the things which I always say, because this is the answer of a question. When I mark something, it means is the answer of the question. Such questions have been asked. You don't have to write lines and lines. Only few things, words are required. So you got it. You have a red pen with you. I'm making your own notes. Are you making your own notes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. There will be the final things for you, because I can show you the path rest work you have to do. What the coaches are doing to the players. They are telling them, okay, this is the way to do it. Then practice is done by the player. Player is not practicing, but he will do nothing. So here you have activation. Why will the activation reduce? That means the pathway is going to change. And we studied about the pathways. Now, what are the pathways? Mechanism of the reaction.
Mechanism.
So it will alter the mechanism of the reaction. You are climbing a hill. Now you will take a different path. You can approach hill from many ways. You know, somewhere maybe it will be easier to climb a hill at some place. So you have to find alternate paths, alternate mechanism. That's what you are talking about. Therefore, the path becomes different. The activation energy gets reduced. Potential energy barrier is lowered, and hence the rate of the reaction becomes faster. Does that convince you? Are you satisfied with the answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here is a picture of the catalyst. Very important. And examples also we try to give you, so that sometimes they only ask, give examples of catalyzed reactions. The diagrams are important, but to be understood. Most of the students just pass and go through it. They don't understand. They don't give time to it. Pay attention to the work. The secret, pay attention to the work which we are doing. This is important thing I'm telling you. Unless I pay attention, I go so fast, then it is gone.
Yes, sir.
The more I think, the more I learn. That is the story of the science. All the inventions and discoveries of science took place by that way. And no discovery stops to make you another improvement or another discovery. Whatever I say today, you can improve it and come to a conclusion which is superior to what we are saying today. Even the structure of atom is under strong investigation. First, you said there are three particles, proton, neutron, electron, which you are all the time using. And then they say there are 35 particles inside the atom. Unbelievable, unimaginable situations. How much we understand, God knows. So the quest for knowledge and the use of those things continues. And man continues to make machines which could help us in identifying and studying those elements, those particles which we believe are still there, and we don't know much about them, nothing about them. So all this is a world, I mean, unbelievable world of atoms and molecules, chemistry, all molecules, compounds. Our whole body is all molecules and compounds, trillions of cells inside your body, unbelievable, unbelievable. Very complex things we are. But a fundamental unit of everything, atoms. Okay, the story ends there. But how much you know about atom, that is the question. All right, so we understood a lot of things here. Coming to the next part of it. Here is something very interesting happening, students. Very interesting things are happening here, students. What we have here. See, what we are showing to you, this is a graph. Number of particles, I am saying, and here is the energy. Originally, this was the molecules which are shown here in this color, which will react. I'm saying originally only the number of particles represented by area under this part on the curve had high enough energies to react. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
These particles which we have shown here under the area, originally these particles were having energy equal to or greater than activation energy. And
okay,
when you added catalyst, what has happened? When you add catalyst, you have done what now? You have added catalyst. ठीक है,
ओके सर.
व्हाट इट डज, इट हैज लोअर्ड द
एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी.
द रिएक्शन विच वॉज टू टेक मोर एनर्जी फॉर टू टेक प्लेस, नाउ इट इज टेकिंग प्लेस एट मच लोअर एनर्जी. देन व्हाट विल हैपन? The number of such particles will become more in the reaction flask, in the reaction mixture. You are doing a reaction. You are doing a reaction. Supposing in this, some reaction is taking place here. How many molecules are there? Millions of molecules are there. You are saying one mole is 6.02 to 10^23. So you have large number of molecules, particles inside the reaction. And if the activation energy becomes less, what will happen? This fraction will increase, as you can see. This is a new fraction. Because activation energy becomes less, therefore the extra, there are extra molecules now, extra particles. So there are extra particles which fulfill the condition of activation energy. Activation energy. Therefore, what is the result of that? The reaction rate will increase. The reaction rate will increase. Right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here we have shown a picture of that. It's very interesting. Unless we pay attention, try to understand, nothing will come out. I am always saying concept should be clear. हमें रट्टेबाजी नहीं करनी, cramming बाद में है, before that understanding is required. Picture should be in our mind what is happening, what we are writing here. To increase the rate of reaction, you need to increase number of successful cleans. What are the successful cleans? One possible way of doing is to provide alternative way for the reaction to happen, which has a lower activation energy. So there are cleans, but what we are talking, effective cleans. Effective cleans, students. Cleans which will form the products. Not all the cleans are effective, that we know. Because you have a factor E minus EAY RT. Yes.
Yes, sir.
This is a fraction of molecules. I thought we did a numerical on that also. Fraction.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So that is the role of the catalyst, which we understood here. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. All right. Next. Then once a question was given on students, what is the effect of catalyst on equilibrium? You know that if we are talking of a reaction, we studied the chemical equilibrium chapter 11th class. You are saying that there is an equilibrium. What do you mean by equilibrium? What do you mean by equilibrium, students? What do you mean by equilibrium, students? You are saying some reaction is taking place and after some time there is a forward reaction, there is a rate of forward reaction and there is a rate of backward reaction.
Backward reaction.
So what will happen at equilibrium?
Both will become equal.
Rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of
backward reaction.
Okay, good answer. So if I add a catalyst, what will happen to the equilibrium? That was the question. I'm saying, what is the effect of catalyst on equilibrium? What is your answer?
Sir, there will be no effect on the equilibrium.
What do you mean by no effect?
Sir, there will be no effect of a catalyst on equilibrium because a catalyst will catalyze both forward and backward reactions equally.
Very good answer given by you. So you understood the basic thing. So yes, this is a question which was given in paper. But the time of equilibrium will be
altered. The time of equilibrium will change. It will be achieved faster.
The time of equilibrium will become less. Got my
point? Yes, sir.
If equilibrium was taking place in 60 minutes, now the equilibrium is taking place in 1 minute. So that is the important point for us. The equilibrium will be attained faster. And that is important in industries, you know, when you are preparing products. The more time a reaction takes, more energy is required. Every reaction requires energy, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Can you manufacture anything in the industry without supplying energy?
No, sir.
So what type of energies you are using, let it be thermal, electrical or anything. And if you have to use large amount of energy for making products, what profit you will get? Your cost will be very high.
Yes, sir.
So we have to reduce the requirement of the energy. Even in metallurgy chapter, you will see that if you are making metals, you have to get it at a lowest cost. Otherwise, they are of no use to us. Then what industry will do? So this is important. What we are saying, okay, read it. Reactions can speed up by addition of catalyst, including reversible reaction. These were examples of students. Reversible reactions. If reaction is irreversible, then I don't talk of equilibrium. You know about it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in a reversible reaction, students, what is happening? The equilibrium state is one in which forward and reverse reaction rates are equal. In the presence of a catalyst, both forward and reaction will speed up equally. That was the point for the exam. What happened? Both the forward and reverse rates will speed up equally. Thereby, along this distance to, however, it is very important to keep that reaction of the catalyst has no effects on final equilibrium position of the reaction. It simply gets there faster. That is my point. Equilibrium will be attained faster. So you are saying equilibrium will be attained faster. That's all. ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
The questions have been asked, whatever I am saying. This. How does it affect delta G? If I add catalyst, does it change that delta G?
No, sir.
What is delta G? What is delta G?
Gibbs energy, Gibbs free energy.
What the delta G tells us, Gibbs free energy?
It tells us the spontaneity of the reaction.
And you know the conditions of spontaneity of the reaction. So this is only lowering the activation energy. What it is doing? We told you what the catalyst is doing. Lowers
the activation energy.
Activation energy. That is the answer to many questions. For example, hence has no effect on delta G. Does not affect
delta G.
This question has been asked in exam.
Okay.
Does not affect. How do you explain the action of the catalyst? That is the question. what we are saying, the action of catalyst can be explained by the intermediate complex theory. You know, when we talked about the mechanism of the reactions, what I talk, intermediate formations, yes or
yes,
no?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Intermediates could be isolated in the product, yes or no, tell me.
No, sir.
No, sir, they were so short-lived.
Yes, sir.
But without them, the reaction could not be explained. Because which step is the rate determining step?
The slowest step of the reaction.
Okay. So reaction, sir, most of the reactions are elementary or complex?
Most of the reactions are complex.
Okay, they take place in more than one step.
Yes, sir.
All right. So intermediate complexes are formed at the top of the energy hill. So according catalyst participate in a chemical reaction by forming temporary bonds with the reactant. So you see that every, why few elements act as catalyst, other don't, see the story. And you will see most of the time transition elements. And we will explain to you when we discuss the transition elements. They exhibit variable oxidation states. And they have d orbitals also available for bonding. So they can form, you see, temporary type of chemical bonds resulting in the intermediate complex. This has a transitory existence and decomposes to yield the products. And the catalyst is regenerated back. That is how the catalyst comes back. Does the mass of the catalyst change during the reaction?
No, sir.
No, sir. Okay. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Understood everything?
Yes, sir.
These are the questions. 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
We can, they can ask any question. We can't stop them. Okay. So Kulian theory, now we're talking of, there is a theory which has been given now to explain the reactions which take place. That is what we're talking of, Kulian theory. The word Kulian means what? Molecules will collide and reaction will take place. That's what you are trying to say. You are saying that A plus B forms products. But A and B must collide.
Yes, sir.
A and B must collide. But not all the Kulians are effective. So first thing is Kulian has to take place. But there are many Kulians which are wasted. So Kulians should be effective. So one of the factor you said is, what is the one of the factor? E power minus Ea by RT. That they should have activation energy. Right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So then he gave a Kulian theory actually. Kulian theory was postulated. They said the number of Kulians per second per unit volume of the reaction mixture is known as a Kulian frequency. So if A plus B reacts with a product, they said the rate can be given as ZAB e ki power minus EA by RT. Okay? That was the simplest formula they gave. What is ZAB, students?
Collision frequency.
What is Kulian frequency? That question was also asked. What is Kulian frequency, students, here?
A number of collisions per second per unit volume of the reaction mixture.
So when this rate was calculated, it was found to be, this rate was very high. This rate which we got from this formula gave very high value. But actual rate was less. Actual rate was less. Now, how do you explain this? That is another question. See, every time we are writing a line, a question is coming. Now, what is your explanation?
Uh, Sir, maybe because when we calculate this ZAB, ZAB gives us the value of total collisions, whereas the actual rate is actually the sum total of the effective collisions only.
That is what we are now written here so strongly. Not all the collisions are effective. Only a fraction of the collisions are effective. So rate value given by this is much, much higher. Actual value will be much less because not all collisions are effective. That's what we are saying. So you are saying not all collisions are effective. Not all the collisions are effective. So what are the collisions which are effective? Interesting thing, we come here. What we are saying, not all collisions, however, bring about a chemical change. A collision will be effective in producing chemical change only if the species brought together possess a minimum value of internal energy equal to activation energy. Further, the colliding species must be oriented in a manner favorable to the necessary rearrangement of atoms and electrons. Thus, according to collision theory, the rate at which chemical reaction proceeds is equal to frequency of effective collisions. I'm saying now. So I'm talking of frequency of effective collisions. Effective collisions. Because atomic and molecular frequencies can be calculated with some degree only for gases by application of the application of collision is limited to gas phase reaction. Actually, the theory was given by kinetic theory based on kinetic theory of gases. Because such calculations are only possible with good accuracy for gases only. So according to the following criteria must be met in order for a chemical reaction to occur. Molecules should collide with sufficient energy. Chemical bonds can break, molecule must collide with proper orientation. So more important thing now here, two things coming. One, you are saying activation energy factor. Second, what we are saying, proper orientation factor. Students, this is also called steric factor. You have seen in organic chemistry. Whenever reactions are taking place, the attacking reagent is coming. If it sterically hindered position is there, then or but how it collides, orientation, steric factor, or they call is probability factor. Represented by P. So another condition has come now. Not only molecules should collide, but they should collide with proper orientation. I'm saying proper orientation. Important point. Two molecules are colliding, but how they are colliding? If the orientation is not correct, then also you cannot form the products. So there will be wastage of collisions also. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's see further what is we are seeing. Here is interesting thing now. Molecules must collide with sufficient energy known as activation energy. So chemical bonds can break. In a reaction, what is happening? You see, when in a chemical reaction, what happens? You are saying chemical reaction is taking place. This involves bond breaking. And bond formation process. Therefore, they collide with proper orientation, you are saying. A collision that meets these two criteria and the results in it is known as a successful collision or an effective collision. So that only collisions will be effective. What we want? Effective collisions to be. For example, see, carbon monoxide is reacting with oxygen gas. Product is carbon dioxide and O, CO2. In the reaction, I said, so you have large number of molecules. If the collision takes place like this, what is the story here? This is carbon monoxide, this is oxygen. Oxygen this reaction, you can see what is happening. This is O2 and this is CO. Oxygen is meeting the oxygen. This is no reaction here. Actually, carbon is the one which takes oxygen. Oxygen is not taking the oxygen, you know, in a reaction. Where the oxygen goes with the carbon? With the carbon. You know about CO2? How we are writing CO2? This carbon, see, it has got how many? Two oxygens. Is it like this? Answer is no. Got it?
Yes, sir.
So this is not effective. Orientation not right. But here you see what is happening. This carbon and oxygen, carbon and oxygen. So it is forming CO2. So this is a reaction. Here we are just trying to tell you that molecules collisions will be there from, it is just a random process when the action starts, but collision should be effective. So steric factor, probability factor has been given by P. What we are trying to modify the collision equation. The collision theory has given an equation ZAB into AE minus EA. We need to modify it. We will give a modified collision. Modified collision equation. So we have to modify the collision. There is something wrong with the mistake. So how will you modify this? By introducing a steric. And organic chemistry, you have seen in most of the lectures, I've been talking about steric factor, probability factor. And we have another important example of organic chemistry here. Very important. This is an example of steric factor. Can you tell me, I have written a reaction here. Which reaction is this? Do you remember? What is this reaction? You have done it? Did you do this reaction?
Yes, sir.
What is the name of this reaction?
SN2 reaction.
Nucleophilic bimolecular substitution reaction of haloalkanes. Right?
Yes, sir.
So what is happening? What we are trying to say that in this, what we showed that you are having, this is your alkyl halide, right?
Yes, sir.
There's a positive charge on the carbon, negative charge on the Br, right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
And the nucleophile attacking reagent, this is my nucleophile. This is my nucleophile. This is a attacking reagent, students. This will attack where? This has to attack the carbon. Okay. If it comes from this side, what will happen? Tell me, reaction will take place or not?
No, sir.
Why?
Sir, because in this case, the carbon will have 5 bonds, which is not possible.
So this doesn't take place. No reaction. This collision will take place in the reaction. I cannot stop it. It will be wasted. Because the Br has to leave and it is coming from the same side. So how it will leave? And Br, you know, is a bigger group.
Yes, sir.
And these are small groups. The size of hydrogen is smaller, you know about that. Right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
So this is not the proper orientation. But what happens then in the reaction? You know about it. That if I have this, this is tetrahedron shape. If OH comes from the back side.
Yes, sir.
And this bond is breaking. This bond is breaking. Plus negative. This bond is breaking. This has to leave. Then what is the result of this? This is possible?
Yes, sir.
Proper orientation. And that's why we told you in SN2 reaction, what stereochemistry is involved, what happens during SN2 reactions to the stereochemistry, if compounds are optically active or something, what is the result of that?
Their shape gets inverted.
If they are optically active, there will be inversion of configuration.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Therefore, they have modified the equation. This is a new formula. Got it? They have asked the question, what is P? P is a steric factor, which takes into account the orientation factor. Any difficulty here now?
No, sir.
Okay. Here are some of the questions to be answered fast. You have only few minutes. They are not difficult question, but they were given in board, so I took it from that. It is written now to Delhi 212211. You can see that.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I give you 2 minutes to go through them and answer as fast as possible. Okay, students.
Yes, sir.
Okay, students, you know about it. This answer you already know. Define the rate of the reaction.
Yes, sir.
Order of a reaction, activation energy. Definitions only. If rate constant is, what is the order of the reaction here? Which order is this? You have to see the units, second inverse.
Yes, sir. This is first order reaction.
You know already about that, first order. such questions will be there in the paper. For our half life is observed to be independent of the initial concentration. What is the order of the reaction? Half life is not dependent on the
half life is observed to be independent of the initial independent means it is first order.
So such questions. Define definition, you know, rate constant is this, how long will it take? This is zero order reaction formula. For zero order, you already know what is the formula.
Yes,
for
sir.
Zero order, apply it.
Yes, sir.
Zero order, that is okay. What is the difference between average rate and instantaneous rate? Okay, you know about it. Rate constant K is given, calculate the fourth life, that also you know how to do it.
What yes, sir.
Formula? 2.303 log, you can try with this formula.
By 8 minus x, yes sir.
A0 by 80, whatever it is. Here also same thing for rate constant, even he has given the value of anti-log, see?
Yes sir.
In the exam.
So directly we have to put the value.
So this formula will be there?
Yes sir.
So here were some of the questions, and this ends this chapter also of chemical kinetics. We did some numericals already on that. This was just to tell you that questions are not difficult. A very easy question will also be there, which are very scoring for us. So those students who are doing good practice, they will be able to do it. So with that, the chemical kinetics chapter is end. So we will be beginning with a new topic, which is the next chapter coming?
Surface chemistry.
Surface chemistry.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we will see you in our next class then, and bye bye. And I hope I know you would answer most of the questions which we asked with you. So it is a good thing, yeah, you are doing hard work.
Thank you, sir.
I am sure you will be able to succeed in your exams. Okay, then we see you next.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye.
Thank you, sir.